facing a bitterly divided Congress, President Biden called on members to come together and finish the job, rebuilding the economy and the nation. In his State of the Union address Tuesday night, Biden clashed with Republican hecklers and appeared at ease, deflecting their open hostility. And he set the stage for what is more clearly becoming his 2024 reelection bid. Senior political correspondent David Cruz reports.
Check it out.
What if you went to a State of the Union and a hockey game broke out? Well, it wasn't quite Devil's Rangers, but for a State of the Union, it was jarring. For Joe Biden, it actually looked like fun.
He's not going to get what he's looking for in Washington the next 2 years. He knows that. And yet he felt completely at ease in this dynamic. And in fact, he baited the other side into standing up and jumping up and down and calling him names.
Not what House Speaker Kevin McCarthy wanted from his caucus, coming off their contentious speaker selection of just a few weeks ago, but perhaps an indication of how much control he doesn't wield over the lady in the white fur collar wing of the party.
This morning is a disgrace. And the reason we're not going to win the majority in New Jersey, or we're going to struggle at the national level, because we let loudmouthed extremists with no manners scream out liar to the president. And as long as the Republicans don't stand up against, in my judgment, an extremist with no manners, we're going to pay the price. And I'm disgusted by that behavior.
Biden looked and sounded like a candidate for re-election, energized by the back and forth of a floor debate, even deftly getting both sides to stand together to endorse the sanctity of Social Security and Medicare.
So tonight, let's all agree, and apparently we are, let's stand up for seniors. Stand up and show them. We'll not cut Social Security. We will not cut Medicare. Those benefits belong to the American people. They earned it. And if anyone tries to cut Social Security, which apparently no one's going to do, and if anyone tries to cut Medicare, I'll stop them. I'll veto it.
The Republican response painted Biden as a hostage to extreme forces on the left. But for some in the president's base, including immigration rights activists like Amy Torres, the president's brief reference to the issue was a big disappointment.
It was raised in the same breath as the words smugglers, right, and fentanyl seizures. These words recall some of the very same narratives that the Trump administration used when they said that they're sending drug traffickers, criminals, and rapists, right? These are really, really dangerous words to use when we're talking about immigration reform in the same breath.
Biden also introduced the parents of Tyre Nichols, whose brutal beating by Memphis police was captured on video and seen by millions now.
Just as every cop, when they pin on that badge in the morning, has a right to be able to go home at night, so does everybody else out there. Our children have a right to come home safely. Equal protection under the law is a covenant we have with each other in America.
This is more than just about being sad because of the loss of a good person. This is about anger towards the system that doesn't recognize our fundamental humanity. And I think that was more than a missed opportunity. It was tragic, frankly, and I think someone needs to follow up with him on that.
The president still hasn't made it official, but as a rationale for re-election and as a signal of what the octogenarian-in-chief still has left in the tank, Joe Biden could have done a lot worse than this State of the Union address. I'm David Cruz, NJ Spotlight News.